Okay, so this is the puppet that we are going to be working with. He's called Jimmy. Hello, Jimmy. How are you? Jimmy? Say hi to people. Wait.
Huh? Hi. Yay.
This is Jimmy, and this is how he's going to look. The final result in which we are going to be able to move his hands, his legs, turn his head and everything. But this is not how we're going to work with him, though. Okay, first off, I started with a sketch. From there, I draw in separate drawings, in separate layers, the left arm, right leg. And then I put in the head, I put everything in a separate layer, the eyebrows, the eyes, and each one of them has a name. Right eyebrow, left eye, left pupil, and I'm gonna go through that. So if you want to come up with your own characters, you can do that by following something like this. You can do this in Illustrator or in Photoshop. Both work great, but it's better in Illustrator because it saves you a couple of steps in After Effects when you want to turn the head. We're gonna be covering that later. Now, this is the head. These are the pieces for the head. I have this eyebrow, then this eyebrow. So we have this side of the face and the other side of the face. The eyebrows, the eyes. These are the eyes. These are the pupils. Why would you like the pupils separated from the eyes? Well, because I want him to be able to look up, to look down, and I can animate every single, whoa, every single part of that. Then the blink blink. Then the nose. Then I have four mouths. I have the sad mouth, then the sad open mouth, then natural or happy mouth, and the natural or, yeah, that's natural, natural mouth. Then I have the head. This is the face. You see the way in which it's drawn? So if you put it like this, it's going to look like, hey, I have this cool hairstyle. Yeah. So that's the head. So now let's go for the body. I did this. That's pretty simple, pretty straightforward. You only put the neck there, then the head. Yes. Super simple. Let's go on, move along. Now the arms. For the arms, I'm using four layers for each arm, actually for each extremity, because the same happens to the legs. Okay, let me explain real quick. You need the arm, then a copy of the body, a copy of that same arm, and then this line that is going to be covering the clothes. Right? So you can hide that line. Okay, why? Well, we don't want him to look like this, right? Like, if you put the arm inside the body, you don't like, looks ugly, I don't like it. You need this, so we can do a technique called mat. And this is important. For the body, you need this, you need to hide this part of the arm, okay? And then the same goes for the right arm. And you do basically the same for the legs. You have the leg, the copy of the body, copy of the leg, then the outline. And this outline is covering the whole cloth, okay? And the pockets. Those go like, yeah. Looks like a pair of sad eyes. No, they're pockets, okay? And the way it's all going to be put together, it's like this. This is what we are going to bring to After Effects. Let me expand it so you can see. This is the body, and you see the four layers for the right leg. Then four layers for the left leg, and then the pockets, the arms, which need these four layers, like I explained, and then the neck, then the face, and then all the properties for the face. Now it's important that you have, I currently have the blinks hidden. So you can make him like, yeah, blank, 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 blank. And the hair is all the way back. Okay, so this covers this lesson. See you in the next tutorial, in which I'm going to show you the tools that we're going to need in After Effects to rig his puppet the easy way, in the most magical way. Oh, exciting! Are you excited? Don't be scared. Let's... Now you're relaxed. Yay. Okay, see you in the next tutorial.